One of the major reasons why we shut down, and a lot of the major reasons why everything was being done across the country, was because there was a fear that there was going to be an overwhelming of the hospital systems, right? And we were going to run out of beds, we were going to run out of personnel. Since we're reopening up, since the hospitals are reopening up for elective surgeries, for these types of regular visits, now we're seeing all these patients come back.
With COVID, we've been focused really on the illness and the deaths associated with it. But there's a whole other story when it comes to patients who are chronically ill and whether or not those patients have been delaying their care.
The idea behind a RAPIDS proposal is to collect information that could otherwise be lost. We believe that this is extremely important because we need to study how certain hospital systems prepared for these things. What were the policies that were put in place? And how did that impact the services that were provided to the patients? And then we want to work with some of the physicians here to potentially establish a tool that they can use to, in the preparation for, say, a second wave or another pandemic down the line. And pandemics are not necessarily limited to just COVID or to diseases. Hurricanes, tornadoes, any types of these things where there would be a rush of patients, these policies that they put in place to prepare for those pandemics and prepare for those surges, they might be able to use some tools, such as a simulation tool that we like to develop for them, to simulate, okay, we're thinking about putting this in place. Can we, using what happened historically, use this little simulation tool to see what would happen to patients' length of stay down the line, to the patients that we're quote unquote not worried about right now, but what will happen to them down the line.
So we just got an initial data pulled from Olivia. There were 5 data sets.
This is where the collaboration with Samaritan Health and the physicians and the healthcare workers there will be very important, because they will know kind of what are they expecting here locally with respect to non-COVID patients and cases that they're looking at. Is it more cardiovascular oriented? Is it infectious diseases that they see during the summertime? And then we want to compare what the demand patterns are for those 2 patient populations, now, pre-COVID and now.
Working with Joe has provided that opportunity to actually look at what happens to these chronically ill patients and what exactly has been the impact in the delay of care.